too. I'm a senior in the band. And like all of the people that spoke before me, I have also been in band for 9 years. I am Abby Goddard, and I am the librarian and vice president of the high school with ensemble.
We'd like to thank you guys all for coming out and supporting the arts tonight. You're going to hear from a lot of really amazing, blossoming musicians. First, the 5th and 6th grade band will play, who's behind me.
And then you can hear the rest of the ensembles that you're at tonight. So again, we just want to thank you all for coming out. The impact that band has on your children and all of your peers and students is more immense than I can ever explain into words. It's been such an influential part of my life, and I only hope that you guys continue to support the band, even after all of us seniors graduate this year. So thank you so much, and enjoy your night.
Hello, everybody. Hello. Thank you so much for coming out to our spring concert here at Fairfield Area Middle School and High School. My name is Doug Conrad. I am the director of bands here at the middle school and high school. It has been such a great experience today getting all this music and all this great music ready that you'll be hearing tonight. So, to start off our portion of the concert, this is the 5th and 6th grade band. We're going to start off with a selection of folk tunes that are from the Appalachian Mountain. And with this, it is in what we call a multi-movement suite. So it has two movements. So we'll play one slow lyrical movement, and then have a short brief pause, and then play the second movement. As this is a multi-movement piece, we ask that you hold your pause until after the completion of the second movement. So without further ado, this is two Appalachian songs arranged by Mike Story. So what you see tonight is only a small portion of the work that we do with our 5th grade and 6th grade band programs. In addition to our ensemble class time where we have all the instruments together, We also have what we call sectionals or lessons, where we have small group instruction. We've had the distinct pleasure over the past few years to have the help of somebody who is an outstanding colleague of mine here at Fairfield Area Middle School. We've had the elementary music teacher, Mrs. Heidi Reiner, come up and help with those sectional rehearsals to really kind of help with a lot of individual instruction that is really needed for the beginning stages of band. So to help and, acknowledge all of her hard work and to work with these students here, we're going to bring Mrs. Reiner out to guest conduct our next piece, which is a slow lyrical movement called Midnight Sky by the composer Brian Balmages. So to give you a glimpse of what we did for part of that, we're going to play the classic band piece, Let's Go Band. But we're going to do it in a little fun version. We're going to start off all together, and then we're going to play a little bit of a challenge game where the fifth grader goes and the sixth grader are going to go. We always kind of joke back and forth which side's going to get stronger and louder and more bold. We'll see that way tonight, and then at the end they're going to join all together. It's a lot of fun. So without further ado, this is Let's Go Band.
Thank you.
Yeah, what we're going to do is feature some of our individual students in small groups. So we're going to feature some soloists, and this was an opportunity for any students that wanted to come for me and audition for a solo to play at the concert. What you'll hear is a lot of kids who are going above and beyond just the usual assignment and expectation for each time we have our classes. So to start off with that, we're going to feature Miss Carolyn Finfrock playing, is there a correct reading wrong? Amazing Grace. All right, so this is Carolyn Finfrock playing Amazing Grace. solos portion now. This is a really fun section. For a lot of people that don't know me, I am actually, my primary instrument is saxophone. So working with this group, the fifth grade saxophone and clarinet sectionals every week, is really a pleasure, a really fun group to work with, and to showcase really something special, to really speak to the kind of students that we have here at Fairfield, really bright, really talented, really hardworking. We're going to now play a quartet that is called Four Part Big Star. And to show you, and they sound really good, but to show you the kind of students we have here, I'm going to have them answer a question.
When did we put this together?
Just this morning. So you're about to hear, I'm just going to tell you, you're in for a treat. So without further ado, we have the fifth grade clarinet saxophone sections playing Four Part Big Star. Abram, take it away.
Thank you.
for just one quick brief stage change. We're going to be right back with you with the High School Chamberlains. One more time for our 5th and 6th grade band. Okay, thank you for your patience with that. So now, what we're going to play for you is, this is what we call our chamberlains. These are the students that, in the high school block, whenever we shift from one day full band to the next day full chorus, these are the students that are just in band and not chorus. So with our orchestration this year, the types of instruments that we have to our availability, it's really cool that we can do some unique instrumental combinations. So with that said, a piece we're going to play now is called Three Years of Clouds by Hugh Amsler. This is in the realm of wind band music, like what you'll hear tonight as a concert band. This is probably one of the top 50 pieces ever written for wind ensemble or concert band. So the chance to play this with a small group is something really cool to do. So again, this is a multi-movement suite. So please hold on to your applause to acknowledge the suite exit at the completion of the third movement. So without further ado, this is Three Airs from Glasser by Hugh Amsler.
Thank you.
High School Chamber wins. So what makes that piece really unique that you just heard was not only that it's a very classic staple in the band literature, kind of like how Shakespeare would be what we call the core literature of an English class, but also that with that piece of music that we just heard, the varied styles, to put that all together in a short amount of time is a real testament of the kind of students we have here in our band program. So after a few more quick stage changes, we're going to bring up the house lights and we're going to feature our high school jazz band. So please just sit tight and we'll be right with you with the high school jazz band.
Thank you.
compositional techniques. So we're going to play two tunes by him. One of what we would say the classical swing variety, and one a little bit more of a funky setup. So to start off with that, we're going to play his classic tune, Milestones, the hottest one for soloists. We are going to feature Bradley again on trumpet. We're going to feature Rachel on trumpet, and then also Brayden on the tenor sax. Without further ado, this is Milestones.
Thank you.
on tenor sax, and Natalie on bass. And solos for this song will be invited to see. Oh, we'll have Rachel on trumpet, we will have Noah on alto sax, and Raiden on tenor sax. So this is how it is. So what?
Thank you.
So our first piece now with Symphony 3 at the end is going to be a piece by American composer Timothy Broge. This is titled Theme and Variations, which it is actually also a form or style of music. So what you'll hear in the very beginning is a theme or a melodic theme played by our lower instruments, and throughout the song what you'll hear is different variations. Maybe it's a variation in different types of instruments that play the melody, or maybe in different styles. Some sessions will be slow and narrow and soft, others may be loud, separated, and detached. It all depends. So without further ado, this is Theme and Variations by Timothy Broge.
Thank you.
So we will have a section actually then playing on hot cross buns, but they will be playing a section of the melody in the song on record, which gives a really neat feel. So this is Ancient Voices by Michael Sweeney. Thank you. So to end our evening, we're going to have, I promise, one last stage change here. We're going to bring on our high school wind ensemble. So please just give us a few minutes and we'll be right back with our high school wind ensemble.
Flourish for Women was written by Ralph Vaughan Williams in 1939. the 20th Century Concert Band. Flourish for One Band was written as an overture to the pageant music that people performed in the Royal Albert Hall in 1939. The score was then lost, only to reappear in 1971. It was not made available to American bands until it was published in 1972. You will hear a solo by Jenna Slaughter on bass clarinet.
Thank you.
do a brief pause and honor our seniors as this is their last performance with the high school band. Many of them have performed in our band program since fourth or fifth grade. So we're going to go down and just go through and acknowledge them for all their hard work and years of dedication and service to the band. So first, please rise when we acknowledge you. First, we are going to acknowledge Miss Abigail Goddard. Mary's University next year and major in cybersecurity. So thank you, Abby. Next, we have Catherine Jensen. Catherine is planning on next year attending Northern Kentucky University and majoring in nursing and minoring in psychology. Next, we have Alexander Dubitz. Alex plans on entering the workforce next year and then plans on attending a four-year college majoring in social studies and secondary education. And next is our bassoon player. This is a student who, to learn the bassoon is almost like trying to build a computer with toothpicks. It's such a hard feat, and we're really going to miss her next year. We have Miss Alexis Ogle on the bassoon. Alexis is planning on attending Underwood International College at, am I going to pronounce this right, Yonsei University? All right, I got it. So she's going to plan on attending there at Yonsei University in Seoul, South Korea. She plans on majoring in political science, international relations, and comparative literature and culture. And last, and certainly not least, one of the best students that I've worked with, I mean, all these kids are great, but a real bright individual, really talented student, not just in the band, but choir program as well. She's the president of our band program here at the high school. We're really going to miss her. So certainly last, and certainly not least, is Miss Emma Burgess. Concentration in digital media production. One more time for all of our bands. So, to move on to our next tune, this is a piece of, or a type of music, I should say, that we call programmatic music, meaning that there's a background to it. When we hear a song sung in chorus, it's easy to understand the context because we have words. With instrumental music, that's not so much the case. So to tell you about this, it's called The Great Locomotive Chase. It deals with two trains kind of chasing each other in the Civil War era. You'll hear some interesting sound effects with a train whistle solo by Francesco. Lots of interesting things going on. So to tell you a little bit more about it, we have Mrs. Abigail Goddard, our singer in the flute section.
Thank you. Thank you.
Otherwise, thank you very much. Have a joyful night, and one more time for all of our student musicians.